Hello, how's it hanging, my dudes? I am Ziyatra and I am back and it's the same day. Why am I recording so much in the same day, you may be asking? I still have no idea, and if you are still curious about it, I am still recording my drawing, my Christmas drawing. I forgot what I was gonna say for a sec. I'm still recording my Christmas drawing. I'm so slow at drawing and I don't know why, but I just prefer to take my time and do the things how I actually like them to be. Okay, so back to the first thing we came here about. Today I'm gonna talk about how I got into Hamilton. Why? Because I love Hamilton. The very first time I heard it, it was awesome. I fell in love with it with the first song I heard, even though I didn't have any idea that it was a musical. So, we're gonna start how I got into Hamilton. It was a slow process, it was kind of calm and everything, and I didn't know what I was going for. I was in Italy back in vacations of last year. I'm 1 year Hamilton fan. I was on YouTube one day in the morning. I usually wake up, grab my phone and watch on YouTube. I was watching a Warrior Cats multiple animated project. I find them quite cool and I want to be an animator and stuff. Back to Hamilton. I heard to this non-stop Warrior Cat MAP and I was like, oh, cool, another MAP I found randomly around the internet. So I listened to the song while I was watching the cool animation the dudes did. And I was like, nah, stop, it's just a song, because like the day after I already knew the lyrics. I found this other song, I remember, so I heard it and I was like, wait a second. These dudes are the same dudes that sing non-stop. Is this a new band that's going on, or are these new singers, new rappers, something like that? But no, later on I discovered that it was a musical, but that was way later on. Okay, so back to the day where I listened to Aaron Burr. So I listened to Aaron Burr, I was like, oh, so cool, pardon me, I'm Aaron Burr, so that the band is asking, oh sure, so I'm Alexander Hamilton. Oh, Alexander Hamilton, who the heck is that dude? It must be an imaginary dude that doesn't exist or never existed in the entire history of this world. But no, I was wrong yet again. Later on, the YouTube recommendation came out. The usual watch again non-stop, watch again Aaron Burr, watch again other Warrior Cats MAP. Then it was like this Hamilton non-stop. I'm like, what? What is this? Is it Hamilton, the name of the band, the name of these dudes or whatever? So I clicked it. And when I clicked that video, my whole life has changed. I clicked the video, it was like the video with the lyrics like, no, stop position, it's not a song, they're kicking around. How many? Then I saw the other songs, like I was non-stop, I remember, so then I think I heard Alexander Hamilton, the first song, then Cameron in Battle. Cameron in Battle number one is my favorite song in the entire musical, and also Washington, Washington on Your Side. Those are my favorite two songs. Then I listened to the other Cameron in Battles, of course, Who Lives, Who Dies, Who Tells Your Story, The Ten Doors Commandments. And then I kind of got into the jam. I didn't know the guy who wrote the entire musical was the run. So movie Moana came out. I was like, dude, Alexander Hamilton is singing in Moana. And my parents were like, what? And I was like, yeah, Alexander Hamilton, the history dude. And my parents thought I was crazy, that I was lost. Bye-bye, Nick. The Moana movie passed, then later on I saw that said Moana, and down it said music made by Lin-Manuel Miranda, and by the time I already knew that Lin-Manuel Miranda was the same dude who wrote Alexander Hamilton, but I didn't know that Alexander Hamilton wasn't, I thought that the dude who wrote the musical Alexander Hamilton was named Alexander Hamilton. Later on I found out the name of the dude, that's Lin-Manuel Miranda. Then slowly I got to know the other names of the other dudes, like Anthony Ramos, who plays as John Lawrence, and Philip Ramos, and then, oh, Christopher Columbus, and then later on James Anderson, then David Dix, that later on plays as Marcus de Lafayette, and Thomas Jefferson, and later on goes into the freaking movie Wonder, which is an awesome movie. I recommend it. You should go watch it. Go watch it now. What are you doing here? Get out. Just kidding. I got to know a few names. I was like, oh cool, this dude is this, this other dude is that. I knew every song. I mean, the lyrics of every entire song. I started to listen to like the nightcore versions where the song goes faster than usual or the sped ups and everything's like, Alexander Hamilton, Mademoiselle Alexander, blah, 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 blah. Like, full speed, just because I want to rap better than David Diggs and faster, even though there's this guy Netflix, who's a freaking rapper, and I love his songs like Life or Fight Back, it's gonna get better. Why am I changing the subject? Back to Hamilton. I was going insane for Hamilton. I was like, Mom, could you buy me this book of Alexander Hamilton, please? And they were like, okay, but you sure you're gonna read it, right? Yes, of course I'm gonna read it. You sure you're gonna read it? So they bought me the book and I never read it all. I mean, I have it and sometimes I just read a page or the lyrics page. It's like, oh, very interesting, but I never actually read the entire book. But I am gonna read it entirely one day and that will be a special day. And which year, I have no idea. Then I asked for the Alexander Hamilton book that the wrong dude wrote. Like, chapter 4. The book is gone. I still have it, but I don't read it. Yeah, that's my story with books. Story of my life with books. What else? Oh yeah, so I started saving up my money since the beginning of the year just to get this year to get to see Hamilton. Did I make it? Of course I did. And it was amazing. I saved up $400 to get the ticket. I started getting more than the music, I got more into history. So thanks Lin-Manuel Miranda and everyone else who was in the musical to get me into American history. Because I was always a history dude, but I never actually got to learn the history of America because I traveled a lot. So I had to be in different schools, in different countries, in different places all the time. But now I'm here, and anyway, I'm good. Hamilton. I started reading fun facts about Hamilton, I started reading about the life of Hamilton, about the life of Marquis de Lafayette, downloading audios about these historical characters and about their lives to learn about it. I mean, I do read that stuff, but I'm not like those dudes who read pages and pages and pages of stuff just to learn, right? No, I'd rather just hear it or have someone tell it to me. Yeah, that was quite my adventure into Hamilton.